Do you have a serger but rarely use it, maybe only to finish edges? Take a break from working and spend an afternoon learning a new serger feature. Plus, you can create and stitch a complete, easy-to-sew vest. Let's start with the steps of learning the cover stitch. I use the Easy Afternoon Vest to create the serger project. It's a single layer of fabric where the outer edges and the hemline have been finished with a cover stitch. It's very easy to work with. A linen fabric is an ideal option, or other woven fabrics. There are two versions of the Easy Afternoon Vest, and this version is the second option where it has a finger length addition at the sides, warming points at each side. Very graceful, again, easy to sew, and we'll be doing this in the second half of this segment using a three-thread overlock stitch. Regardless of which pattern you're going to be working with, choose fabric that can be used on either side, that the right side and the other right side is attractive. There may be a slight variance, as in this tweed, but still it looks workable on both sides or attractive on both sides. When working with the Easy Afternoon Vest, you'll get some tissue paper patterns included that you're going to trace off your sizes. Now, I have pink and green tissue papers of the front and back. There are only two pattern pieces, front and back, that's it. You'll see from the difference of the green to the pink that the pink has a wider shoulder seam. You can have a traditional shoulder seam or a slightly slimmer shoulder seam. And at the very hem, you can have a gentle curved hem as in the green, or that fingertip length that you'll see in the tweed vest. The same changes are evident on the front piece. Just two pieces, slightly different shoulder seams, and the change in the side seam with that fingertip fashion area. Cut out your fabric. Again, woven fabric, something drapeable that has the right side and the other right side, and then do some basic sewing. The sewing is of stitching the shoulder seams together, front and back. Stitch the center back at the collar area. This is of the front piece, and then the neckline seam. So shoulders, neckline, and center back. I chose to clean finish the armholes. Just serge the edge and turned under and top stitched. Really simple. But the fashion statement, the interesting statement, will be in the center front and the lower edge, finishing it with a cover stitch. The pattern has a 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, so on my ironing board, I pre-pressed all the remaining edges, measuring that 5/8 of an inch, and then pressing. And obviously, this has been pre-pressed, but you'd press under your seam allowances to the other right side of the fabric. You'll have a funny little corner, and we'll take care of that during the serging step. And that's what we'll do next. The cover stitch is the star of this segment, where we'll finish the edges of the vest, making it reversible with this great stitch. And to do the stitching, follow the reference guide, the threading guide on the Evolution. There are four options for cover stitch. I chose the triple cover stitch, the very widest stitch, using all three needles, more of a decorative than a secure stitch, and then the cover stitch finishes the raw edge and closes the raw edge on the wrong side of the fabric. I've used all-purpose thread and kind of a contrasting color. And before I sew or serge on my vest, I do some testing. And remember, we pressed under the seam allowance, and you stitch from the right side of the fabric where you see the three straight rows of stitching, and the underside catches the raw edge of the fabric, or should cover it. The first time we did it, it didn't. You can see, we didn't have the guide set correctly. We pressed under more than we should have, and that certainly wasn't covering everything. So the fabric guide, which I have on the sewing table of my serger, can be adjusted with these screws so that you can guide it so that the stitches and the cover stitch will encase that raw edge. So do that testing, first of all, and set the guide. On my small sample, I've pressed up the hem, as you saw earlier, as well as the front. And it's not a complete vest, it's just a portion of it. And we found serging the hemline works best to do that step first, and then do the neckline stitch. So raise the foot, get the fabric aligned with the fabric guide, lower the foot, and serge. It's really all in the testing. Doing the sample making or sample stitching on the same fabric, and then just sew at an even speed and within minutes you'll have the hem complete. Then after sewing this, I'll show you how this has encased the raw edge. It's encased the raw edge completely because it's done its job. Then the next step is to sew the front edge. So it'll be from the hemline to the hemline, right around the neckline. And here's this little additional seam. So we'll tuck that under, forming a point. And you'll do the same on the other lower edge of the front. What I like to do is to start serging in an anchor cloth when I have to sew at a corner. So just on a scrap piece of fabric, start serging. Give yourself a little tail that you can pull, and then I'll remove the pin. Raise the foot, get the fabric underneath that foot as far as possible. Because there are quite a few layers here, that's why you need this little extra tug. I'll straighten it out once again, and here we go. We'll be just right on task. And just do the serging. The extra anchor cloth will soon be trimmed right off. And you'll be serging from hem edge to hem edge. I just have a portion of the vest front right here, just as my sample. And I'll cut this off. And then we'll take a look at the corner, and we have a little extra thread tail. You can see this thread tail, and we would clip this and thread it through the serging area. And let me show you on the finished garment. As you look at the corner, we've taken some time to thread that through, making it completely even and finished nicely, and then just do a final press. You have the cover stitch and the triple stitch. Here's our vest on the dress form. The fabric drapes beautifully, but the cover stitch has made this garment reversible, and you can sew it in an afternoon. Another feature that you could use on your serger is a 3-thread overlock stitch. This version of the Easy Afternoon Vest features a woven fabric, kind of tweed, and we've chosen the length that is tipped along the side seam, longer at the side seam, about fingertip length. We have to use some specialty serging techniques to go along these longer edges. The two vest shapes that we're working with today have a subtle shaping at the hemline, and the one I'm working with this time had the deep tip fingertip length at the side seam. To serge the outer edges and the neckline are what I'm going to show you now. Mention 3-thread overlock stitch, and you're going to check your owner's manual for setup. I've checked my Baby Lock Evolution quick reference threading guide to know exactly how to do a wide overlock stitch. The thread choices that I'm working with are decorative thread in the upper looper and lower looper. I've used a Core 6 from Madeira, and then just all-purpose thread in the needle. Now to thread this, you can simply thread it through the upper and lower looper portholes. And with thick threads, sometimes you need to use a lasso. Cut 24 inches of 2 threads, meet the ends of each pair together, put one in the upper looper hole, the other in the lower looper hole, and then push the serging lever to the threading position. Hold on to the loop ends and then push the thread, and it's magic. The lassos go through the ports. Next, put the thread ends through the lasso openings and manually pull them through. It works very quickly for thick threads if sometimes they don't go through the threading ports. Do some testing, first of all, on your sample, and I'm going to show you kind of what may happen with your fabric. If it's stretchy, like this one is, it stretches a lot at the tip length, at the fingertip length. Now we're going to be trimming off the seam allowances at the front as well as the lower edge. And if you would just serge with the overlock stitch and just let it stitch, when you're done, you may find what I have. Granted, my fabric was a little bit as a full weave to it, a loose weave, but look what happened to the edge without any support added to it. Well, there are two ways that you can change this to correct it, and one is to change the differential feed, the way that the feed dogs bite the fabric. Normally that's set at the end for normal. We want the feed dogs to bite just a little bit more fabric. I tested my fabric and found to tighten it to 1.3 was the best option. Prevented that waving. The other option, a nice combination to go together, is to add a strip of wash-away stabilizer. Place it on the top or bottom, it doesn't really matter. And I'm going to combine these two options of trimming away the seam allowance, serging over the wash-away stabilizer, and have the differential feed just a little bit tighter so that it's biting just a little bit of the fabric. And as I serge this, you'll be able to see the difference between the two seams. You'll be serging as I'm doing, serging maybe the hem first of all, then followed by the front area, and then at the end you'll leave yourself a little thread tail that you can wrap to the underside and catch. But here's this edge that I just serged. It's flat because the feed dogs are biting the fabric. I had the stabilizer on the top. I'd simply remove that, and after serging the hem using the same technique, I'd have quick and perfect serging accents. Here again is our finished garment. You can see it drapes nicely, the edges are attractive, and with a little serging practice, you too will be able to make this creation. I hope you've enjoyed learning how to use your serger plus create an attractive vest or even two of them. Learn more about the Evolution Serger and the products used in this video, visit a participating Baby Lock retailer and ask about their special offers. Tell them Nancy sent you.